Next topic is replica set. How we are going to scale pods? What happens when pod goes down? I think that is the next set of questions that we have to answer in our workshop now. Let's understand what is missing in pods. One of the things is scalability. How am I going to make multiple pods of the same application running? How I'm going to bring reliability? If pod goes down, how it's going to come back again? And that's the question that we have to answer using replica set. Replica set is an abstraction over pod, which ensures that a specific number of pods, which is also called as replicas, are running all the time in the Kubernetes cluster. How it does that? Using a reconciliation control loop. So you have a desired state, which is being requested by the user, and the current state, which is the state of the Kubernetes cluster right now. You observe the system for both the sides. If there is any new request submitted by user, or if there is anything has changed in the current Kubernetes cluster, if there is any pod goes down or anything like that. You figure out the difference between desired state and current state. After that, you act, which means you take actions to reach to the desired state. So that's how your reconciliation control loop keep running. Observe, diff, and act. And if you remember, which Kubernetes master component does this job? Control manager constantly runs the reconciliation control loop for you. So the job of the replica set is to ensure that the pod or homogeneous set of pods are always available. Maintain the desired number of pods. If number of pods exceeds, kill the excess number of pods. Launch new pod in case of any failure, deletion, or termination of the pod. To associate your pods to replica set, it uses labels. Let's look at the labels. So labels are key value pair that are attached to an object, any object such as pods. So each pod can have labels associated with it. The key value pair, both are user defined. So key also is user defined as well as the value. On the other side, you have selectors. Selector helps identify set of objects in Kubernetes cluster using equality based or set based matching. So replica set, which defines selectors, needs to match with the pod. So all the matching pods will become part of the replica set. To define replica set, you have to use descriptor YAML. First part is your API version. You define which kind of object you're looking at, which is replica set. Metadata information, where you specify name of replica set. The template part of the replica set, where you define the pod specification. With this, you don't have to specify separate pod.yaml file. All the information about the pod are part of the replica set description itself. Within the template, you have spec, which is similar to the pod spec part of it, and it defines all the container related information. One of the key part now you have is the labels inside the metadata attribute of your template, which is pod template. So you are applying these labels to your pods, and selectors is a part of replica set. So replica set defines that, okay, which selector I have to use to match my pods. And you have key value pair, which is specified here, which is matching to the key value pair you have specified in the labels. You also define how many numbers of replicas you like to have for your replica set. That's how you define your replica set descriptor YAML. Let's look at this in action. I have two terminal window here, one constantly watching on pods, and another one that I started, which is looking at replica set. So let's look at how many replica sets I have in my Kubernetes cluster now, no replica set. There is a short form as well available, which is RS, says no resources. Let's go and look at the replica set YAML. This is exactly similar, like you will notice. The kind is replica set. Replicas, I have given two. Selectors is doggy pod and metadata label inside my for template is also Dobby pod. So now I'm going to run this replica set. To apply replica set YAML, you have to say kubectl apply. You'll notice that I have replica set to desired count, current count two. Two containers are getting created. As soon as they came into the running state, it is ready to serve the request. Now let's do one more part. Go ahead and increase the number of replicas here to 6. Reapply the replica set file. You'll notice that there are 6 containers started, right? Ready 4, waiting for other to come to the ready state. Since node 1 doesn't have the image, just taking time to download the image. Also notice that all the pods are distributed across all 3 nodes that I had. Okay, desired count, current count, and ready count all matches, and we are good with the replica set. Let's go ahead and look at the description of the replica set. You'll notice that it has created all the 6 pods described here. You will have all the information related to the replica set. If I do kubectl get pods --- show labels, it will show me that I have label applied to the pod, which is app dobby pod. Let's do one fun part. Let's delete one of the pod and see what happens. Kubectl delete pod. We have deleted this first one, which is getting terminated. And you'll notice that immediately the 6th pod is created, the new pod is created, and it is in the ready state running now. The desired count of 6 pods is always managed and maintained by the control manager, which is defined in the replica set. Let's go ahead and create a pod with the same label that I had in the replica set. Let's try to apply this YAML, which is simple pod, but same label that I have inside my replica set here. Let's see what happens. See, the pod got created, but it's again immediately terminating. Why? Because as soon as you have the 7th pod, which is with the same label showing up in the list of pods running, control manager comes into action and deletes the pod. Let's watch it again. Started and immediately terminating. Started and immediately terminating, right? Is visible, correct? Going and reducing this to 2. Let me delete the replica set. So all pods are gone, no replica set. We'll first create the Dobby pod with labels, just the pod. Dobby pod is created and with the label that we have specified. I'm going to run this watch with labels. So I can see the label in this pod. I have this replica set where I've reduced the count to 2. I want to apply this replica set, but the label is same. See what happens. You will notice that only one more pod is created, right? Because I had already one pod running with this label, and replica set is looking at that as a group and assuming that I have already one pod running, I just have to spin up one more pod. And that's how the reconciliation control loop works. It is purely based on labels and selectors. Let me delete all the pods. And everything is gone. Even the pod which was created independently got deleted because replica set came into the picture looking for all the labels, killing all the pods matching the label. We looked at the replica set demo. How do you know that the application is ready and serving request? Many times we have noticed that application is in hang state. You need to have a health checkpoints, right? Which we configure in our load balancer to make sure that the application is always checked whether it is healthy or not. Similar way, Kubernetes also has a concept of health check probes for containers. And these diagnostics are performed periodically by Kubelet. The readiness prop helps indicate whether the container is ready to serve the request. And it halts sending any new request until the probe is successful. The liveness probe indicates whether the container is in healthy state or not. And this could be different from the readiness probe, right? So for example, if I have my application connecting to database, in that case, if database connection goes down, my container is not able to connect to the database, I am not able to serve any new request, so I am not ready to serve the request. However, my container is still in a good shape because my container has the ability to reconnect to the database when it comes up. So my liveness probe will serve as good, so it indicates whether container is good or not. However, it is not ready to take any request. That's how you can use the readiness probe and liveness probe in combination. And when liveness probe fails, it indicates that the container is unhealthy and it restarts the container immediately. So these two are used in tandem throughout the lifecycle of the pod. There is one more probe available, which is startup probe. It protects slow starting container so that my readiness and liveness probe can kick in only when the startup probe is successful. So to do this probe, there are three types of checks possible or available in the Kubernetes world. The first one, which is most used, is HTTP, where you have a health point configured or available inside your application. If it succeeds, then this probe is successful. Another one is exec command, which is like running shell script command, which exits successfully, which means things are good. And third is the TCP socket. It tries to open a socket, and if it is able to connect to the socket successfully, then the probe is good. To know more about the probe specification and different parameters, you can look at the Kubernetes documentation. So how to define the readiness probe in container spec? Remember, this readiness probe is defined at the container level. So readiness probe, I say that I want to check for HTTP GET, path is slash readiness, port 4444. Initial delay before I start checking for the readiness is 20 seconds. And every 3 seconds, you keep checking, application is continue to ready, serve the request. Same for liveness probe, it is checking at slash health endpoint. So I have my Dobby application, same replica set, replica count 2, container defined here. See the part here, readiness probe and liveness probe is configured. Okay, let's deploy this. Kubectl apply. I have my 2 desired count, not ready yet, waiting for getting ready. The containers are running. It takes initial 20 seconds before it starts checking. So one pod is in ready state, both the pods are in ready state. looks good. If I go to Dobby application, there are many endpoints available. If you want to make your Dobby application sick, you can hit this URL and it will start returning 500 for the health check. If you go and make this, if you go and call the ready sick endpoint, it'll make this readiness endpoint turn 503. So we'll use both of this. First thing that I want to do is go and hit the readiness endpoint sick. So I'll change my 1.7. So I'm making one of my pod returning a readiness pro as 503. Okay, so we made this pod not ready, right? The ready count here also decreased. So only one of my pod is ready, in ready state, correct? Now let's make the pod unhealthy. I'm making the same pod as unhealthy. Notice that the restart count will increase to 1. And it will become ready, which means that if containers is not healthy, Kubelet is going to restart the container. See the restart count increase to 1 and it will start checking the readiness pro. It should become ready in a few seconds. Okay, cool. We'll do it again one more time. Go. Again, not ready. Next, I'll make it unhealthy, which is Liveness Pro. So Liveness Pro, as soon as it starts getting error, it'll assume that the container is gone unhealthy and it has to restart the container. You see the restart count increase by 2. Cool. Okay, now let's just make the container not ready for some time, right? But container is healthy. It is returning Liveness Pro successful. So it's working fine, right? So it's now not ready to serve the request. In Dobby application, there is a endpoint which again makes you perfect. So you are ready to serve the request. So you'll notice immediately the ready count became 1 of 1 and ready count here also. So that's how the whole Liveness probe and readiness probe works. Exercise 3. In exercise 3, we'll continue on metadata service. We'll create a replica set for metadata service and deploy in Kubernetes cluster. We can use Liveness and readiness probe using the Spring actuator health and metadata service is having some other feature. And you can create a metadata entry into the database using the simple HTTP post message. So you do a curl post with some data to the pod IP and metadata endpoint. To get all the metadata entry posted using the curl post, you can hit the get. So it will return all the list of metadata that you have posted.